I'm at least at back reporting.
I'm getting really good feedback from people in the boxing world, people in the boxing gyms, you know, the kids that are coming up in the amateur world. I haven't heard from a lot of pros, but I heard from a lot of kids and gyms, like, you know, the people in the gyms have been really excited. That's cool. And everyone who's in my movie was excited.
Of course.
And everybody over at Atlas Caption Kids in Flatbush was excited. And, you know, I think it's honest. And if anything, there's criticism for, you know, the people and their mentality and the era. And I can't change that, you know. Like, I actually read a review yesterday that said it's no Rocky. And, you know, that guy can... I'm not making Rocky. I didn't try, and I don't want to make Rocky because, you know, I'm not really interested in brain damage stories. I want to tell uplifting stories.
Okay. Can you do, Jay, would you do a sequel? Would you do a sequel or a whole new boxing documentary, or was this it for boxing? You're going to go on to other things?
Wait, say that one more time?
Are you going to do a sequel? Are you going to do part two, another boxing documentary?
You know, if I did a sequel, maybe it'd be nice to, like, do a documentary about the Renaissance of boxing in England. You know, they're so successful right now.
It's absolutely.
Like, how is that happening? You know, like, in spite of, you know, on the contrary, like, they're, whereas in America it's doing, you know, whatever, in England they, like, have so many champions right now. Like, what is happening there that is creating such success? I would be interested in that. I haven't endeavored to do it or really tried. I just thought in my head a good sequel to this film would be like England Boxing 2018. You know?
Okay, we're talking to Jay Bugler, Jay Bolger. Last question. Canelo, okay. Triple G, break it down.
You know, I was looking at the weigh-in yesterday and...
You mean the face-off?
The face-off, right. And GGG looks a little bigger than him, huh?
He probably is, yeah.
It's such a hard call because I don't think he's faced anyone like him. I want to say that Canelo's going to win a decision, but, you know, then I watched this GGG versus Butte amateur knockout yesterday. I was like, God, you know what? Right. All I know is that I thought Danny Jacobs beat GGG, and I, therefore, but at the same time, you can't really take Danny Jacobs' victory or my opinion of a victory into account because he's a different fighter than Canelo. So I don't know how to apply that knowledge that we saw from the Danny Jacobs fight.
This is how you could say it.
It's going to be really close.
Yeah, no. You could say that Canelo's improving from fight to fight, and Triple G looks like he's slowing down. That's what you could take from it. But Jay, tell everyone where to follow you on Twitter, where to follow you on Instagram, to watch the movie.
Cool. Right. It's Jay Bolger, JayBulger on Twitter, and my movie's on Netflix. It's called Counterpunch. If you go to Netflix.com, it's a big banner that says it right there, and I would appreciate more boxing fans checking in, and hopefully I created some boxing fans because I love boxing.
There you have it. Jay Bolger, people don't know, he boxed. He was the only white guy in the gym back in the day. He was like Eminem in the movie 8 Mile.
Or it was Whitey Bulger.
Whitey Bulger. There he was, Whitey Bulger in the gym. FusionReport.com and Malisic back reporting. So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. FusionReport.com, I'm Malisic back reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Secback.